3 is the magic number they just played.
Yeah, it was so cool.
On the way out, because yeah. Congratulations, you just had triplets.
Yes.
See you then.
That's why he does what he does.
He's the best.
I know, man.
Tell me about that. You have triplets that run around the house. I mean,
it's a full-on assembly line.
It really, yeah.
Yeah.
It's an assembly line, yeah.
It's like,
yeah. They're all changing diaper. Change diaper 3. There you go. Burp. And then you burp. There you go. And then burp the third one. And then go to sleep. Go to sleep. How about that? That's the best.
Yeah.
This is the greatest. Oh, come on. That is so
man, I have
fun.
To say, like, man, my wife carrying those babies and all of them are fine and healthy. And man, I cannot say enough about women and all kinds of burdens that they carry and the gifts that they carry. I just can't. My wife is everything.
I mean, seriously, yeah.
I love you, baby.
Yeah.
She's the best.
And it's just a madhouse, probably, right? I mean, I'm assuming.
No, it's no joke. They harmonize when they cry. You know? It's real. And then, you know, chain reaction is a real thing in our house. Like, it's a real thing. One cries, two cries, three cries.
They do what each other do. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because you have tons of other things happening around you, but to find time to do that and be a dad is an awesome thing. So props to you as well.
And I have to just being dad.
Yeah.
Because I'm super dad. Rocket is like into architecture now, so we're excited about that.
Absolutely.
He's like, he spends so much time on Minecraft. It's like, we're worried.
I don't quite understand. I played it with my nieces and nephews and stuff like that, but I don't understand what I'm doing.
Dude, me either.
But he digging holes. And
he builds the most amazing little houses.
These kids are all going to be like these geniuses growing up and architectural geniuses. Like building castles with, I mean, my nephew Nicholas is just, it's insane. It's like he should sell them.
Well, yes. I've had architects say, dude, I'd build that because he builds modern homes. He's like, Dad, this is modern, Dad. This is modern beach house.
I'm telling you, the future is going to be you buy real estate, digital fake real estate, and build homes on it and sell those things.
Oh, yeah.
I'm telling you.
A cross between...
I'll be your neighbor.
Minecraft and Vanilla Sky, yeah, all day.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I want to say congratulations to you. I don't know if to call you Pharrell or doctor.
Okay.
Because you received your doctorate, and that's what I'm talking about, Dad. Look at that. And... NYU, you gave the commencement speech. NYU, you are a doctor. You got your doctorate, and you spoke at Yankee Stadium.
Yeah.
And it was a great speech, and I just kept thinking, like, man, oh, man, he must be so nervous. But
and hot.
And hot.
It was so hot.
And you're wearing the whole...
Yeah, yeah.
You're wearing
no,
the hat.
Real.
You got the whole
real.
Thing. Yeah, yeah, the whole... But, I mean, this is a cool thing because your mom was a doctor, right?
Yes. And... You know, when she first got her doctorate degree, I used to tease her all the time whenever we would get into, like, debates.
Yeah.
You know, you just want to be a little facetious. Well, whatever, Dr. Williams, you know, da-da-da-da-da. And now she does it back to me, and it's so awkward and so weird.
It's full circle. It's perfect,
yeah,
man. It's perfect that
she got her doctorate in education, so she doesn't have a stethoscope either, but I just kind of feel like there's no jacket, there's no, you know, there's no, like, discount at a fast food place.
I could probably get that for you. I could hook you up. I could hook you up with a McDonald's.
It's super awkward, though.
I want to talk about Despicable Me 3. Yeah. Man, I don't know how they do it over there at Illumination, but they've done it again. It's a clever movie. Again, there's a new villain. Trey Parker plays. Steve Carell's in it.
Who kills it? He's so good at it.
Trey Parker or Steve?
Yeah. Trey Parker. I mean, Steve is always.
Steve is the double role, and it's just amazing. But as soon as I heard your new song, I go... What is this song? I'm like pulling my Shazam out. I was like, why don't I have this?
Oh,
dude,
man.
You're just so talented. It's so good and it's fresh. And it's always new and different sounding. And so I just loved it. I just thought it was great. So congratulations on that.
Thank you.
I mean, Despicable Me 2. I mean, you guys ever heard the song Happy? I mean, they played it once or twice on the radio. Oscar nominated. I mean, and now you're back. So have you done stuff for every movie so far?
Yeah.
All the Despicable Me's.
Yes, they have been very good to me. The Despicable Me franchise and what it's become has just been, it's been amazing. It's opened so many doors for me. And, you know, the fact that they don't, like, try and hold me to do the same things over and over again, just like the themes change, that, you know, I'm allowed and given the space to continue to grow and explore and be curious as well.
It works,
so it's awesome, and they know what they're doing.
It's a good team. We have a clip from Despicable Me 3. It's in theaters on Friday. It's great. Take a look at this. Hold on to me.
Don't let me go. Hey, get that back!
I mean, come on. It's so cute. It works. Pharrell Williams, everybody.